I am starting my daily standard game against a German player with rating of 2001. I decided to play every day a game, so I would like to improve my rating. So it's an English defense, and he played g3 in the second move. I will play g6. And continue development. I'm mirroring him, but my plan is actually to change the mirror soon. Probably now I will play e5 to control d4, so preventing him to play d4, and I want to play knight e7, castling, develop that way. I gave up the d5 square, but I hope to regain later the control on that by playing knight bc6, d6, bishop e6. So I allow him to weakening that square, but I gain some space, so I have a little space advantage. He can have an interesting maneuver with the knight, knight e1, knight c2, knight e3, and then knight d5 to control the square. Probably I will exchange to e7 knight there, and then the other knight may go to e7 to fight for this square if it's necessary. I think this setup gives a close to equal position for black. White may also try to play like rook b1 and then a3 and b4. Against that, I may do a5 to control the b4 square. White can also just develop with d3. Okay, so he played knight e1. I guess he is going for that plan which we discussed. Knight c2, knight e3. I need to develop anyway. That's the square for the knight. And my bishop needs to go to e6. Okay, so he has the control over that square. Just continue the development. So this setup was played many times by Botvinnik with reversed colors. He played this with white many times. So d3, he continues the development. Probably the best square for my queen is d7. I think to play d5, but d5 is controlled 4 times, and I support only 3 times. So that's not an option. Okay, so I'll probably just develop. Later I may play f5, f4 or so as an idea. On the queen side, maybe a6 and b5. Okay, so he wants to play b4. So one option here is to just play b6 when he plays b4 and just go for the defense, or I can also play a5. Actually, I would like to play d5 some way, but I really can't. With knight d4 is an option to do something, or if I just play f4, f5, it puts the knight to d5. I cannot take the knight because it forks the pawn, so probably I need to take the bishop. Okay, let me just stop this one and look how it goes. Okay, now knight b6 is a threat to fork my rook and queen. So I move the rook probably to d8 or e8. e8 looks more reasonable, because that 5 may open up later. Knight f6 is an interesting idea. If my bishop would be not there, probably. And sometimes you can play like bishop h6, died of bishop takes h6, then knight f6. So he played rook b1, supporting the b4 move. It looks like he's on the way to succeeding with his plan to attack the queen's side. What should I do? Knight d4, then he plays just e3. I may play bishop h3 to friend exchange. Probably I will do this to make create some activity. If he plays knight b6, I can play queen e6 to cover my bishop. He takes, I take back. And takes b4, I take, take. Probably exchange on d5 also, and then make exchanges here. Take, take b4, take, take. Take on d5, knight takes on d5. So let's first exchange the bishops, that's for sure. So my queen can help this way. I need to also exchange the 8-pawn, otherwise that would be just far away. Probably I take here, I should take with the knight to protect this. And then we make exchanges here. Can I take here maybe? That looks like gaining some time for me. If it takes with the knight, I take it, take with the rook, and then I take d5. Sometimes I will threaten to take maybe e4. Okay, let's do this one. Because this knight will be unprotected in some variations, which can be maybe helpful for me. This is a little bit weak, but even if I lose that one, I hope to get enough counterplay in the center and on the king side. He may play something like queen b3. Request a friendship from him, and I say hello. In the chat, he plays quite well. Yeah, queen b3 is As we fought. Okay, the d5 is hanging. Yeah, normally I would take on c4 too. At least if he captures back with the pawn, then he will have also their pawn, which can be a target. So the two different ways to play d4 or play capturing. If I play d4, then the c4 will be defended, can be like a defended pass pawn if he wins the b7 pawn. So I want to avoid that. So I think that's then there is no question. I should take it. Yeah, when I realize I will need to look the beginning again, because it looks like he just simply got this b4 move and then my b7 pawn is weak. But I played kind of natural developing moves. Yeah, here maybe this was one question, because if I play with rook d8 and then b4 then b6, then actually I can avoid to get that weak b pawn. Maybe this was one possibility. Okay, so captured with the rook. It's maybe a good news, because if I play now rook c6, then bishop a3, my other rook can be in trouble. Okay, so let's look, move the rook. Can move the rook to b8, or I more likely move the rook to c8, or for the exchange. Actually, this can be even good for me in an endgame, like I have like a pass pawn. If it would be more advanced, like it would be b5 or b4, it would be really strong. It can be now weak. If he can attack it and win it, then it's weak. If it can advance, then it will be strong. If he plays rook b4, then maybe this check can be a good to win something. Because if knight e4, I can play f5 because it's pinned, unfortunately. Okay, maybe then it's not that good. How it looks first. Actually, if this, then maybe I can sacrifice, just back on the knight d5. That helps me to exchange pieces, exchanging the rook. Because I think, and then I play b5, and then rook b8, and then my pawn is fine. And actually, it's an advantage instead of weakness. Okay, captured. Probably I should capture back with the rook. So, to develop it. Okay, so knight e4. Let's look, f5 would be nice, but my f-pawn is pinned. What is his threat? Maybe he wants to play like knight g5 to attack my f7 pawn. I would be really happy to play b5, moving up. Queen d5 was an idea to exchange queens, and then I can move the left pawn later, but if queen d5, he makes change and play knight d6, double attacking. Yeah, there I can also play rook b8. And b5. That's maybe an option. If I play the knight c6 with bishop, and this queen is just active, let's try to exchange it. I was opinion. So if he moves the queen, then maybe I can play something like f5. Probably he will take it. And I will recapture. How? What's the position? Well, time-wise, so I have a very small time advantage, like half minute. The position is, I think, very close. Probably this is the moment when I kind of equalized. I think I'm changing the rook that helped me. But if you please, queen b6. I played f5 then, yeah. Queen b4. I'll still play f5, it takes my knight to capture, check. King g1. It's interesting still. Looks okay, we come back here. This can be for the line of something even stronger. Knight c6. Queen takes b7, rook b8. Okay, changed. Let's hope to be able to play b5 and b4. Okay, so b5. Other ideas, rook c2. So be active if he plays. Rook b1, I take it, he takes here. Yeah, my back rank has some issues. If I play b5, rook b1. Ah, that's a trick. I play b4 if it takes. I play rook b8 and it's pinned. So I win it. Oh. b5, knight d6, rook b8. Ah, that still looks good. Okay. Ah, let's hope I can push that pawn and go behind. Because then, instead of a weakness, it will be a strength. This is what I hoped when I allowed this. Probably white made some mistake, because like in this position looked good. Maybe it was not that good. At first I thought it would be. I would probably capture with the queen, and if rook c8, then queen b from back. Okay, yeah, interesting. Maybe it was not that clear. Because the queen c6 has a threat. But if you would capture back with the d pawn and then b7 was hanging, perhaps that's maybe a challenging situation. I would probably play rook b8. Going for the endgame. Okay. Actually, I am quite happy about this. If nothing special happens, then because I will have this pass pawn, which gives me some advantage. So yeah, let's exchange. Okay. Probably wants to come in with knight d6, so I reposition my bishop for a little bit. I want to come out with my king like f6 or f5, king f7, king e6. But I wanted to prove a knight d6. Okay, so I decided to move back. Okay, his bishop is a little bit limited. Play knight c3, moves probably king f1, knight a2, bishop 2b2. The first question is if I play f5 or f6. Actually, if I play f5, maybe the e5 pawn can be a little bit weak. Like after knight, after bishop b2, you can quickly attack. I'm not sure if I can quickly defend. So I may just wait with that quick advance. Bishop b4 and bishop c3 was an idea. Bishop b4, if he moves back to e4. Okay, then move to e7. Interesting. Probably he even wants to go to b3, I think, to block my pawn. And that will be quite a good blockade. Which will be not an easy way to break. I need to get my king into the game. The question is more important to get the king into the game with f6 and king f7 or bishop b4, knight b3, bishop c3. Okay, let's just come with the king. So I also keep e5 defended. Plays like e4, then I play knight b4 to get this pawn. Okay, knight b3. Okay, let me just come closer with the king. He may want to play d4 time to time, maybe now. Take, he takes back, my pawn is hanging, I can play b4. I need to be careful about that. If I play king e6, if he plays d4, I cannot take because this is hanging. Okay. Which I'm happy to exchange bishops in the knight endgame. Should be a very good chance to win, because when we have just knights on the board, so we should evaluate the position like a pawn endgame. And the pawn endgame probably should win for white, for black, because of this outside pass pawn. So this is why I'm offering the exchange of bishops. If he moves back, then question how to go forward. If I play king e6, then d4 comes and I cannot take. Probably I need to move this pawn forward, so I need to move the bishop back. Okay, so maybe this bishop b4 was not a big idea, but at least I made an attacking move, challenging a little bit my opponent. It's really important to try to make uncomfortable moves for the opponent, because constant pressure, he may make some mistake. Okay, this looks something like a mistake. First, at the first point, because a bishop should be better than a knight in this kind of positions. Because pawns on both sides. It's theoretical, let's look how it goes in practice. Should come closer, that's for sure. Okay, now the question, how will I move my pawn forward? Probably I need to go the king to c6, b5, a4, move the bishop on the pawn. Okay, so he prepares the advance. So Let's bishop b4, bishop d6. If you play this one, I will need to take it. Not necessarily. Okay, just go here and then play b4, king b5. To advance, maybe his best idea is to come and protect his knight. King b2, b4. King d2, king b5, king c2. Actually I cannot do much there. Interesting. Maybe changing the knight for the bishop was not a great idea. There's still too many pawns on the board, which helps the player with the knight. If I play f5 here to fix the pawn in the dark square, so my bishop may attack it. Okay, let's do that. Normally, exchanging pawns helps the player with the bishop because then the position opens up, which is good for the bishop where the diagonals are avoidable. Even I exchanged the double pawns from him, but anyway, that double pawn was not a long term weakness because after he would play the d4, then it would make undoubled. So e4, well, this is a question what to do. If I play something like f4, yeah, my pawns will be blocked in the wrong color. I don't like that much. I don't like that idea. Play something. F4. Take. Check. That's interesting. Or d4, that's more interesting. What if d4? b4. e5, move back. Comes. Take. Interesting. Maybe this f4, f5 was not sure this was that good idea. Unfortunately, this knight is so good. It is covering everything. Yeah, the positive thing about f4 move, it's I will have like two pass pawns disconnected, and he will have connected. But normally against the knight is hard for the knight is harder to fight on his pass when they have more distance. But f4 exchange, d4, b4, e5. Bishop moves. Looks really interesting. This. King d3. King b5. b5. Back. d5. think. Some of these pawns look just stronger, that's the problem. This connect, the power of connected pawns. I do now. Play b4, plays this, and I cannot really go forward. Should I play something like h5? Or plays, can make easier the pass pawn? Probably not. I need to somehow improve my bishop. Maybe try to go behind the pawns. But if I bring here my king, theoretically that would be an idea to try to get here my king. Without the bishop and the knight, yeah, to bring his king there and then win the pawns here. But the problem now, he can just have his king also here because his knight blocks perfectly my passed pawn. The knight is a very good blockader. g4, he wants to play probably. h4, so I block that one. Yeah, I want to block them as soon as possible. That's a question where he will move to king. Probably he wants to play like king f3 and then moving up the pawns. Maybe probably bishop h4. If he plays for a win, he may try to use his knight to help his king, but then my passed b pawn may get a chance to be active. Okay, at least temporarily he did that one. Okay. Let's look if he wants something active or he's just playing for the draw. Probably he should be happy with the draw, with the blockade, and then I cannot do much. I may try to maneuver my king to g5 and try to break in this way to attack this pawn, or the other way to attack the other pawn. From I think in this situation he will just move, put his king there, and then I attack the other one, then he moves the king there. Okay, so this is the other chance I may have if he tries to win and moves the knight away from the defense of the c5 square, yeah, which he did not do. Just moves back, looks like. So probably this will be a draw. Okay, I will try to maneuver my king there. Oh, so he moves the knight. Okay, so it's going to be a question now how it will go. Looks like he plays for the win. So maybe he may be right. Yeah, if you play knight f3, then a lot of problems. You can just block this side also with the king. I cannot move in. And then again, his knight just covers everything. Perfect place, perfectly together with the... the pawns. Yeah, that's unfortunate. Okay, my last chance if I play like b4, king b5 to go a little bit further. I may have some kind of tutsulang if I move up here. For now, if you place this, then just move king c4. So I should play b4 when he plays king e3. Let me try king b4, king a5. Yeah, maybe it's time to accept the draw. Looks like he don't want to make any move of the skin e3 maneuver. Okay, what if bishop b4 then h4, and I don't like that h4 and h5 he may move. One more thing, I can try to move my king to the other side. Okay, probably it's best to maybe to draw now, because Yeah, I fear if he plays knight d to knight f3, he may be better even. He did not offer a draw, I did not offer a draw, so we play on. I think maybe this was already a few times this position. But if my bishop will be on e7 or on g5, that's for sure. Okay, I have actually another idea. What if I play b4, king c, b4, king c4, king b6, but then he plays king d5, king b5, take. That's just too strong. Bishop c5. Sometimes if you make so many moves, then the opponent makes a mistake because he will be bored or just too tired. Look, this, if this will happen this time or not. Looks like he will not make a mistake. All other possibilities looks too risky if I play like king d6, king e6. started. So can I just like play b4 and bishop c3 and then try to force him to go, but the problem is his h and g pawn just goes forward, they go forward. Probably we had like this position 5 times already, so it's more than enough for the 3 times repetition. And maybe it's time to accept draw. Okay, thank you for the game. So let me analyze this one. Start with. Okay, let's go back to the starting position. I download it and I will open up my software and we will look from there. So it was a very close game. Maybe in the end game, I think I had somewhere some advantage. It looks like later I missed this one. So let's look at the game. I think the opening was pretty close to it, I'm nearly sure about that. I counted this, d6, d3, knight d3. This looks good, but okay, so here starts the things which maybe I missed. So instead of bishop e6, let's look at the reference first. What did other players play in this line before? Maybe just immediately go for rook b8 and then a6, b5. Yeah, interesting. Rook, bishop e6, which I played, that's the most frequently played move here. It's logical, but maybe bishop e6 is not that good because after knight e5, I cannot take on d5 with the knight because of the fork will come. So maybe better if the bishop is not there, so I can take them with the knight if I want to. Yeah, I would like to look a little over what the best players played here. So I want to make an order of rating. The reference. Interestingly, Molahov, 2007 player, also played this once, white and one. Okay, so let's look. So Gelfand against Rochelle Le Grave. Interesting. F5 and then G5. That looks very interesting. Interesting idea to go all in very aggressively. D3 and G5. So what I felt here, just if I mean I play like F4, then the E4 square will be also weakened. I did not feel how it will be really strong. Maybe just play G4 and without F4 and then H5, like in a King's Indian. Go straight and attack. So okay, so F5 is one idea. And black was rook B8. I actually like this idea to maybe use a bit more. And A6. And be aggressive. Oh, it's interesting. Bronstein play this once. Knight B4. I like this. Wow. So controlling you. D5, and even like B6, Bishop, B7. Yeah, this looks just great. If you play something like this, I'm happy to capture it. Just in Bronstein played A5 and then F5 and King H8 here. But yeah, even this, if it's just blocking the position and then playing on the king side, there is no attack for white like in our game. So probably I will do next time this one. Rook B8 and A6. Okay, let's look what happens. So Bishop E6. The most frequently played move actually. Oh, wow, even Grischuk played it. I went 1-1 and lost also 1. Grischuk. Nakamura played it, so should be good. Grischuk beat Aronian with this, wonderful. So my opponent played here D3 and I played, I think, Grischuk's move. Queen D7. A3. Okay, maybe I made here the mistake. So I did not continue with Bishop A3, which, yeah, it would be kind of logical. Somehow I just remembered some old line which I studied when I was young, where after A3, A5 was played. Probably that's just unnecessary loss of time. So Bishop A3. Taking. Probably F5, yeah, I'm just leaving that, okay. I Yeah, I'm probably going up, up. F4. Exchange, exchange, knight, knight e7. I'll just leave him there, and rook f7 and rook af8. Continue the pressure. Probably this is equal. The white has this knight knight, but black can exchange any time. In other words, the power structure is kind of symmetrical, protecting each other. Yeah, this attack is not that strong for white, because yeah, the b7 is protected. On the king side, black has some attack. So probably, yeah, we needed to play like this. So I'm going for bishop a3. Yeah, I played a5. Yeah, in this move order probably this is not the best idea. You can more likely say it was a wrong idea. Ed8. Et5. Yeah, and it's already there are problems. Interesting, so it's really one thing which to get from this game is really need to think about the logic behind the moves, not only just try to remember variations. Because I played this a5 in this, which I remember some long time again, long variations before. But probably in this time it was not a good idea. It's better just allowing b4 and playing b6 or attacking on the other side quickly. Yeah, I played here rook e8, probably this is just continuous to the wrong path. If would be the if I would look the future, then probably I thought about the future I would play rook b8 here. Cover the pawn and we had to play b5 later if I want to. If it plays rook b1. Maybe just go out from that pin, from that fork on d5, so move the bishop and then knight takes d5 is an option again, and then move knight e7 to neutralize it. Well, bishop d2 and b4 is coming. Knight. Ah, interesting, if the knight captures, then after b5 even black is better. So white should probably carefully to capture back with this one. And the bishop is a little bit in trouble. And this b4 move is strong. Something like this needed. Fortunately this knight can escape. F5. Because if this is probably this pawn is vulnerable, this is better for white. Yeah, this is also not a dream position. I played rook e8. Rook b1. Bishop a3. Knight b6 was just strong. I planned queen e6. Maybe knight b5. Oh my god. The knight c7 is a threat. Well, the exchange. And the queen has not many squares left, actually. Well, just not losing the queen. Wow. This is strong, and now f4 is a threat. The queen is just in so bad shape. Wow. Interesting. So here bishop g4 was necessary. So don't exchange the bishop, because that's just allowing this knight b6 tempo move. But after bishop g4, it was okay. B4 comes, then yeah, the interesting thing about this. Yeah, I thought this can be just kind of bad because of the b7 eyes with the pawn. Maybe this is not that bad, how I thought. Because if b5 possible, then maybe it's equalizing. Or close to, probably white is still less pressure. Because of the d5 square and the d6 pawn. Maybe it's just a small edge. Let's look what happened. Bishop a3, he played b4. Wow, and interesting. The computer thinks this is equal or just very, very small edge for white. This is the kind of position which the computer can defend very well, but for humans it's kind of hard. Exchange there. It was a question which way to do it. Wow. The interesting thing is this is the bad move, because after the exchanges, this is, well, it's really interesting. This is just good for white, that BC. Oh my god, this is that strong, because then bishop c4 will come. Well, if rook c4, then queen takes c4, that's okay. Well, it's probably b7 pawn will be lost. Because rook b1 comes. Wow, so the another important part, so not playing like d5 but knight c6. Please maybe f5 and it's probably equalizing and defending on the 7th rank. Wow, that's really interesting. So can't we play with e5, e4 or f4? The b7 pawn is protected. Okay, so we did not take it. Probably that would be better for him. I need to capture with this. Probably I looked here, we should capture back with this d pawn. And I think again the b7 pawn is just dead. If I protect him, d1. Yeah, rook b6 may come. And then this one. Yeah, it's interesting, this exchange of knights helps white. Yeah, you can play e4, build up that protected pawn and attack the d7 one. This is a strong position for white. Yeah, you capture with the rook. Play knight. Again, rook c8, again, mistake. Made a mistake because he played, can play bishop a3. And having tempo moves. Okay, what would be better instead of that? That move. Yeah, because here, if capturing on c4, then this is just too strong. Because knight d5 may come. And the white pieces are much more active. So here again, knight c6 to keeping the knights and covering b4. Oh, and the knight e5. See, I moved the rook because bishop a3 was a threat. Knight c6 is threatening to counter attack. This may be. Okay, so this and b5, and this probably. Give us an advantage for white, but a small one, because the king, the bishop is kind of good defender. So rook said, let's look a bit later how it goes, if it was something critical coming. Because here I felt maybe my position started to be a little bit better. Maybe it was not true. Probably. Bishop f3. Yeah, I thought maybe this one. This. Probably I should play f5, and this is not a problem because I can play b4. It's not in a danger. Knight c6 can block his bishop on b2 if it comes ever there. So maybe f5 was, this was the first move to get something stronger. Knight d2. f6 again, this looks a bit passive. Maybe this was just an equal. This knight on b3 just neutralized the attack. Yeah, I captured here, but what else? Probably this was just equal. Capture king coming b4. King, yeah, coming. Probably this f5 just goes to directly to an endgame, which with not much chance left. So maybe it's better to keep some chance alive, like play maybe b4 here. Yeah, I was thinking about this kind of position, may give some chances, but actually probably no. Still, just again, the B pawn is blocked forever. And after f5, we made another 30 move without much chances. It was just a draw. Yeah, my question was over what happens if I would play like this. This looked a little bit scary for me. I thought to play this. It's interesting, even if he moves, maybe I cannot do much. Wow, that's okay. Yeah, for me it was scary, maybe if he comes with the king to block and we can do something with the knight and the pawn, that looks like he cannot do much. Because he just need to go back and defend. Okay, it looks like this was also a draw, and then we made so many moves and just repeating 10 times. I was waiting for if he moves something like this, and I hope to play up, probably this was still a draw. And this looked like an interesting way. Wow, look at what, you can just do this and then again block it. Yeah, this is also a draw. Okay, so interesting game today. I need to play the opening better next time. But with black, it's normally, if white plays fine, then the draw is the normal, it's a normal result. So thank you for watching and see you tomorrow.